In this video, I'm going to be showing you everything you need to know about railings in Revit. We're going to be covering all of the different ways to place railings. Then we're going to be looking at all of the little settings and adjustments that you can make once they're placed. And most importantly, finally, you're going to get a simple and direct answer to the most frustrating question when it comes to railings in Revit. And that's, where exactly are all of the settings for each individual railing segment? Let's go. Now, before we jump into Revit, I would just quickly like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up just below this video in the description, and then also up in the cards above. There you can find all of my Revit courses. I've got over 140 hours of content, and I'm adding more each month. For example, I have a course exactly on this topic, which is stairs and railings in Revit, so you can check it out there to learn more. Now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And here we are in Revit, and as you can see here, we have some stairs and floors and ramps. But first, let's learn how to place railings. So railings, they're located, or the railing tool is located on the architecture tab, on the circulation panel, and here we have railing. Now you'll notice that we have the railing tool up here, but we also have a drop menu. And here we actually split that into two tools. The first one is sketch path, which is kind of the default option. And then we also have place on stair or ramp. Now let's start with the sketch path. Now also, if I just hit the escape key, or if I cancel out of here, you can also get to this by simply clicking on the railing tool here. So you get the basic draw tools. It's very simple and straightforward. You come wherever you want and then you start the drawing. Now one option that I would like to encourage you to check is this preview option, which will basically draw railing in 3D. So as you place segments, it's going to be showing you what they look like in 3D, which I think is super useful. Also, the chain option is something that I tend to keep turned on. And then now you can move this around, and it's going to give you that 3D preview, which is nice to have. And then I can just simply hit finish. Now, what you'll also notice is you have this option to flip railing direction. Now, in this case, we have a pretty simple railing, so that's not going to make much of a difference. But if you have something a bit more complicated, which I'm going to be showing you how to do a bit later on in this video, well, this is really useful to have. Okay, now let's move on to placing railings on stairs and ramps. So here we have a stair, then we have this is just a floor segment, and then we have a ramp. Now, railings can automatically be placed on stairs and ramps. So you basically click on here to place. You check the position, which can either be on treads or on stringers. So in this case, we don't really have stringers, so I'm not going to check that, obviously. I'm going to keep it on the treads. Here you can pick out which type you want to use, and let's go with the pipe option. And then you simply come and you select the element, and you have your railings exactly there. And then we can do the same thing if I go here to place it on the ramp here. And it's not going to work on any other Revit element. Now you can still adjust it here. So if I come in here and if I just orbit around a little bit, what you'll notice here is that this is kind of on the edge. Perhaps if I turn the thin lines on, you can see that it's basically kind of falling off the edge. So if you want to fix that, what you can do is you can select it. And here we have the offset from path option. And actually, I'm just going to check both of these and add a value of something like minus 20 millimeters. And when I hit apply, you can see it moved. And now it's exactly on that ramp or on that concrete, and it looks fairly good. So you can adjust these things accordingly if you need to. Now let's explore something a bit more complicated. This is nice to have that railing going on the side, but what if you want to do something a bit more interesting? So let's say you want to add some railing in the middle here, but you don't want it to go straight up. You want to go kind of zigzag or something. Well, what you can do is you can go into level 1 floor plan. And actually, let's go into level 2 floor plan. I think it's going to be a bit easier to sketch it out. Okay, so here, if I go to railing, and then let's go by sketch, and I'm just going to pick out that pipe option. And if I just go here, zigzag side to side, something like this. So I can create this railing here. Now it's currently at level 2. I'm just going to drop it down to level 1, hit apply, hit finish. And when I go to the 3D view, you can see we have that railing, but it's just on the ground there. However, we can still host it up here on the stair by going to pick new host. I can select that stair and it's going to come up on the stair. It's actually going to recognize where the stair ends and it's going to give us a break there and it's just going to continue horizontally on this floor here. However, we have a problem because after that we have this ramp and there it seems to be going through the ramp. You can see it's basically embedded inside of that ramp and that's definitely not good. Now this is actually an easy fix. What you need to do is, or what I prefer to do, is to go to one of the floor plans, and in this case level 2 floor plan works better. Go to the split element tool and then you can just find that railing and just split it like this. Now what you'll notice, if you go back to the 3D view, it dropped way down here. Well, that's because it's hosted on level 1, so it dropped down to level 1. Now you can just go to pick new host, select this, pick new host, select the ramp, and now it's adjusted there to the ramp, and this is what we have. Now it's following the ramp perfectly here, and it kind of continues on that railing. So if you have a situation where you need that railing to follow, this is what you would do. And then if it's showing some issues, you can always go to the path, which is down here. So perhaps go into level 1 to fix it. And then you can just move it here a little bit if necessary. And then you can just kind of judge how that's going to change. See how now it fixed that little joint or gooseneck that we had there. So now it looks a lot better. So there we go. That's how we can split railing in order to kind of fit multiple hosts. Now, splitting railing also works well if you want to add an additional post. So this is something that we're going to be talking about in a minute here, but here, for example, I have this railing, and what you'll notice is that here we have this gap where we don't have glass. Same thing goes here and here as well. The reason for that is because Revit usually places, of course, if you tell it, and I'll show you how to do that, but it places posts on the beginning, any corner, and the end of each railing. So if you want to add a post, you can just come in here, you can go to split element, and then you can split that railing, and it's going to add that post there. So this is just something that you have as an option if you want to add additional posts easily. Now let's talk about the railing structure. So our railings are compiled out of multiple elements. Most of them are loaded in as separate families, and then they all come together as a railing system family. Now this can be quite complicated, so let's now go through all of the elements that create the railing and where you can adjust those. So in this case, you can see here I have this railing, and let's now start exploring it. So I'm just going to select it, and then I'm going to go into edit type. And now let's start exploring and go from the top, which is the top rail over here. So the top rail is the one in orange. For the top rail, I can come in here and we have in the type properties, the top rail, and there we can make all of the adjustments for that. Then we have the regular rails. They are in yellow over here, and those can be adjusted in the rail structure. So that's under construction. We have rail structure, and then you have to click on edit to open up the rail structure, and here you can edit rails. In this case, we have 4 of them, so we can name them, we can add different heights, we can even insert new ones by clicking on the insert button, and we can apply different profiles and different materials. Then let's move forward to the vertical elements, which are balusters. Now for balusters, they're here under the baluster placement, and if you click on edit, you get this menu to edit the balusters. Now they're divided into 2 types. In this case, we have those smaller ones, the round ones or circular ones, and then we have the rectangular ones, the bigger ones. Now the smaller ones are regular balusters, which are basically located everywhere along the length of the railing. and they can be adjusted over here in the upper part for under the main pattern. And then below that we have the posts. So the posts are located usually on the beginning, at corners, and at ends of your railing, and they can be adjusted over there in that same menu. And then finally we have the handrail. So the handrail is basically an element where you can, well, grab it by your hand. It's another family. We actually have two options, so we can load or create two different handrails, and they're located under here, under handrail 1 and handrail 2. And they're also a separate family which you can adjust. So if I click on the type, you're going to get this menu where you can make all of the adjustments for that handrail. Now with theory out of the way, let's go straight into practice, and I'm going to be showing you how you can create this type of a rail in Revit. So I'm just going to go here to architecture, I'm going to go to railing, and then let's pick out just the regular pipe railing, and let's go into edit type, and I'm just going to duplicate this one and call it pipe 3. Let's call it new pipe 3 new. Okay. Click OK, and then let's place a segment here. You always want to place a segment of railing just so you can have something there, and then you can start making your edits. Actually, let's make it a bit longer. Just I like to have more balusters there in between those. Perfect. Okay, so once we have this in place, let's now go into edit type and let's start making some changes. Now you can actually preview all of the changes that you make, and it's actually really useful by clicking here on the preview window, and then you can see a segment of your railing here. It's actually in a 3D view and you can kind of orbit it around, so that's kind of useful. So anyways, let's say that for this railing that we're creating, I want to have something a little bit different from this. So here we have something quite simple, and let's say we want to change the top rail first. Well, I'm just going to go here to top rail, I'm going to go to type, and instead of having this circular one, let's click there and let's open up the drop menu, and we have this elliptical one, which I prefer, and then I can click OK and apply, and now as you can see we have that elliptical rail there on top. Now I can also come back here and I can actually set up the material. So for example, if I want to change the material and I want to use something like wood for this top rail, I can. So let's find something like, let's use this birch wood. I like that. Hit apply. Okay. Apply again. Okay, so now we have that. Now in this case it's the we can't really see it because it's, I think, it's set to some default shaded view, but this will be now wood. So if I go back here, go to realistic, you're going to notice that this now has that wooden top rail. There we go. Okay, now let's go back to edit type, and now let's adjust our rail structure. So for the rail structure, I don't want to make any changes. I'm actually quite happy with this, so we can explore this menu, we can change the material or something, but I'm actually quite happy with this, so I'm just going to leave it as is and OK out of that menu. Now I do want to make changes to the balusters, so let's open that up, and then here for the balusters, what I want to do is I want to have the posts be a little bit bigger and a little more pronounced. So what I'm going to do is go here to the balusters, and then I'm going to pick this one square 50 millimeter for all three of these. Okay, and then for the balusters, I want them to go from the post, which is going to be the base. So on the bottom, they're going to go from the floor or the stair where they're hosted all the way up to top rail. However, for my regular balusters, I actually want them to be to not go all the way to the top rail. I want them to stop at that rail number 4. So I can just adjust that here. Oops, not rail number 4, rail number 1. There we go. So I only want them to go up to here. So I can just adjust that there. And then also distance from previous here, it's set to 1000. Let's drop that down to something like 600, just to make it a bit more interesting, like so. Okay, perfect. Then I can just OK out of that menu. So it's already starting to come together. Let's now go and add a handrail. So here for the type, I can just click here. So it's going to open up that menu here. And then we can make some changes there. So for example, in this case, let's go with the pipe wall mounted. And also, I like my supports, so that's basically what's holding the handrail in place, to follow the same spacing that I've added to the balusters. So I set it to 600, so I'm just going to set that number here, apply, okay, apply, let's see. So handrail, and then we don't see it because the position is set to none. So if I set it to left and then hit apply, you're going to see that we have that handrail there. The material is set to this green material because I've just been playing around with those settings a while back. And then let's hit apply, okay, and let's see what that looks like in the model. So if we explore it here, there we go. Looks really, really good. You can see these are the supports that I've talked about. So they're kind of following the same pattern as our rail is, which is really good. So that's basically how you can assemble your own rails. Now, as I said, you can also adjust the rails once you've placed them. So we can't really adjust everything, but we can adjust something. So for example, in this case, let me just show you, if you want to move this support, so let's say this support, it's on the baluster and you want to make it here at the post. You want to move it towards the post. Well, you can actually do that by hitting the tab key once or twice. Then you can select just this element, you can unpin it, and then you can kind of just slide it along that rail towards the end, and now it's just kind of set up to be adjusted to that post. Now let's go to our original railing where I've shown you how everything is adjusted. Now here we have this railing extension, which is kind of C-shaped. Now if I just select this and go into edit type, if I go to the top rail, you can see that here, if I open it up, here I have added the extension. So here we have the extension for the beginning, and I've added an extension style post, and the length is 200 millimeters. So that's why we have this extension here. However, this extension is also something that can be modified. So if I use the tab key again, just to select that top rail, and if I unpin it, so here, make sure it's unpinned, I can go and I can edit that rail, and I can actually come in here and I can edit the path. So I can delete these two elements, for example, and then I can go to, let's go to arc, go from here down to post, something like this, and then create an arc like that and hit finish. And finish again. Well, now we have something really interesting. So we have this railing that ends up like this. So there you go. Those are some of the adjustments that you can make to your railing in Revit kind of after you have placed it. So I hope you have enjoyed this tutorial on how you can create railings and just how railings work in general inside of Revit. Now, if you want to get access to my Revit project files, like this Revit project file here, or some of the other ones, I have over 500 project files on my Patreon page. You can check it out by following the link in the description just below this video or up in the cards above. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.